Hey there, it's Peter from NextEnd, and I've got something awesome to share with you today. You know, Smart Slider has a whole bunch of incredible features that can make your sliders look absolutely amazing. But guess what? Some of these gems are pretty well hidden. So today, I'm here to unveil the top 10 hidden treasures of Smart Slider that users like you have been searching for. Let's get started. Ever wanted to keep some content in place while your background images slide by? Well, guess what? It's a piece of cake with Smart Slider. Just hit that Add Slide button and choose Static Overlay. Now, let's enter this new slide we've just created. Anything you place here stays perfectly static, meaning still, while the other slides move seamlessly behind it. It's pure elegance. Let's take a peek at the preview and see it in action. Slide through those slides and you'll notice that your text and buttons remain rock solid while everything else glides beneath them. It's simplicity at its best. Now let's flip the script. How about keeping that background image in place while your slide content moves around? Go to the General tab of your slider settings. Scroll down until you find Slider Background Image and select an image. I'm going with a darker background this time. Now, save those settings and scroll back to the top. Hit the Add Slide button, but this time create a blank slide. Enter this slide. Voila! The slide's background is now visible, and you can insert content right on top. Repeat this process. Add as many slides as you would like to have and spice them up with layers of your choice. See? They all have the same sharp look. Ready for the preview? Let's go! As you flip through the slides, the background remains rock steady while your content takes the stage by moving in front of it. Now, imagine your slider is all about showcasing images. But what if your visitors want to see those images up close? Well, the good news is you can do just that with Smart Slider. Head to your slider settings and find a Slides tab. You'll spot an option called Backgrounds in Lightbox. Flip that switch. And guess what? You can even choose to display the title and description of your slides at the bottom of the lightbox. Let's go for it. Time for the big reveal. Click on a photo and watch the magic unfold. Voila! A lightbox pops up, and you can seamlessly switch between images while the slides move in the background too. Here's one for the content wizards out there. Sometimes you want to showcase the content you store in custom posts. Smart Slider's got your back, so you can put these on display too. Let's create a new slider or enter an existing one. For this example, I will create a simple slider. Press the Add Slide button and select Dynamic Slides. Here's where the magic happens. Choose the WordPress posts, Dynamic Slides. Here you can find all the custom posts of your website. Like in my case, the portfolio's custom posts. Select your custom post type. You've got some options to filter which posts you want to display, such as categories, tags, or more. Pick your flavor. But now I will keep it simple and use the default settings to show the 5 latest posts. In the blink of an eye, the featured image becomes your background and the post title sits in a heading layer. As you can see, all your slides are automatically generated from those custom posts with the same design. Pretty cool, right? Check out our dynamic post customization guide in the description for more design inspiration. Now let's talk about customizing those dynamic slides. By default, they all have the same design. In my case, they have brown backgrounds. But hey, we love customization, don't we? I sure do. So let's close the preview and go to the generator settings. Scroll to the bottom of the page. At the generator settings section, the slides value defines how many slides you would like to generate, and the start index is from which pose the generation starts from. In my case, I only need one slide to start with, which should display the first post. Let's save this setting and off we go back into your slider settings, so click on the name of the slider. Now duplicate the dynamic slide as many times as you want to get generated slides. Once that's done, hop into the generator settings of the first duplicated slide. Scroll down to the bottom of the settings and change the start index number to 2. Now this dynamic slide will beautifully showcase the second post in your lineup. Save the generator settings. Then enter the slide. Ready for a different color? Let's change the background. And how about some matching hover color for our button? Let's give it a hover state makeover. Select hover state. And change the background color. Keep the creativity going and do the same for all your dynamic slides, just don't forget to increase the start index value. This way you can fully customize them. Now, what if I told you that you can spice up your fonts in Smart Slider? When you go to Text Style tab to choose a font family, you'll see a list of fonts ready to be used. This list was made by our designer, but guess what? You can easily make it your own. Let's do it. Go to your slider settings page or to the dashboard. Enter the global settings from the top right. And then explore the font section. This is where you can find the previous list. And define the default font family. So you can tweak, customize, and adjust them till your heart's content. Now let's see what happens when we add the heading layer. Check the Style tab. And as you can see, the new default family is right there to be used. And check this out, the new updated list is just a click away. It's a font lover's dream. You know, fonts aren't the only things you can customize as default. Yeah, that's right. Enter the global settings one more time. And go to Layer Defaults. Right here, you'll find the font and style settings for all our layers. Let's make some changes to the button's font settings. How about Open Sans for the font family? And let's make it 14 pixels for the size. Apply these changes. Now check out the style settings. We're giving our button a purple background. There you go. Our button's got a fresh look. This way, every time you add the new button layer, it will come out looking this good. Exactly how you want it, right? Let's talk about how to decide which slide starts the show. Sometimes you want a different slide to kick things off. By default, the showcase slider begins with the first slide. But hey, maybe you want to lead with another slide. It's all about first impressions, after all. Head over to your slider settings page to the slide list. Open the menu of the slide, which should be centered, and select Set as First. Now, if you take another look, when you reload your slider, this slide will take center stage. But that's not all. Check this out in the settings of showcase sliders in the Animations tab. Do you see that carousel option? It's a game changer. With carousel off, your slides have a clear start and end. It means no jumping from the first to the last slide. Or vice versa. But here's where it gets exciting. Switch that carousel setting on. Now your slider becomes a never-ending loop. The last slide appears before the first and I can switch in that direction. In the same way, I can go to the last slide and switch towards the first. Keep in mind that you'll need enough slides for the carousel loop to work. Remember, one slide, one spot. so with just a few slides the carousel loop is a no-go. For example, with 3 slides, I would need the left slide to be on the right side too. That cannot happen, and that is why a carousel loop is not possible with this slider. If you're low on slides, no worries, make more or duplicate what you've got. And now for a touch of magic. Imagine showing slides only when it's the right time. For example, even ads vanishing when the event's over, or product sales appearing precisely when they start. To make it happen, let's edit a slide. Make sure that the slide element is selected. Next, head over to the Content tab settings and scroll down to Publish On and Unpublish On. See them? Turn on Publish On and set your start date and time. For example, my slide won't appear until October 12th. Cool, right? Now flick the switch on Unpublish On. If I want my slide to bid farewell after a week, poof, it's gone. The date and time comparison happens with the general settings of your website. And that, my friends, wraps up our hidden gems. These are the top 10 hidden features in Smart Slider. We hope you've had fun and learned some cool new tricks today. If you enjoyed this video, show us some love with a like and don't forget to subscribe if you want more cool content in the future. Have a fantastic day!